The next tab over is the Meds tab. There are three sections on this screen. The first is Inpatient Medications. These are meds that are currently active and scheduled to be given during the patient's time on the ward, or medications that have been discontinued or expired during his admission. We can see here that Robert has had several medications during his admission that have been discontinued, but no current active medications. If his medications were marked active in the inpatient section, we would be able to give them as scheduled through our medication administration software. These are labeled discontinued as a provider has deemed them no longer necessary and canceled them in the system. An expired medication in this section indicates that the medication was scheduled to stop by a certain date. We may not pull out or scan discontinued or expired medications. They won't show up in our medication omnicells or barcode administration scanning system. The next box down is non-VA meds. These are medications that the patient receives in an outpatient, non-VA pharmacy. Please note these meds. Often, a patient may be currently taking these medications, but as they are not dispensed through a VA pharmacy, they are often missed when a patient is admitted and his medications electronically entered into the inpatient system. The last box down shows outpatient meds. These are medications the patient receives from a VA pharmacy in the outpatient section. Let's talk about the status of medications. Medications are labeled as active, pending, active/suspended, hold, or expired. Active medications are those that the patient is currently taking in the inpatient or outpatient setting. Pending indicates a medication that has been ordered by a provider but has not yet been processed and verified by the pharmacy. In the inpatient setting, we are not able to scan a pending, expired, or discontinued medication. We'll need to wait until it is activated by a pharmacist. Active/suspended medication means that someone in the outpatient setting is currently working on this order. Likely, it is in queue for a refill. A medication that is marked as hold means that this has been placed on hold by a physician and no refills may be generated. A medication that is labeled as expired or EXP means that this medication was likely ordered over 1 year ago and has expired. Medications are typically ordered to expire after 1 year, but please note that even though a medication may be marked as expired, it does not mean the patient is no longer taking this. Many patients still continue to take medications after they have expired in our system. We can double-click on each of these medications for more information. A box will come up where we can see the prescription information, including the drug and dosage, and the schedule. We can see when the patient was, or when the medication was ordered, and by whom, along with the start and stop date. If the medication is an outpatient medication, we can see the refill amount and history of refills. Also, where the patient typically picks it up. Then lastly, we may see order checks, such as creatinine clearance, polypharmacy, duplicate order, drug or drug lab interaction. This is good information if you are worried that a medication might have negative interactive properties with another medication, or if you are concerned that the medication may be negatively impacting the kidneys, for example. Now, if we were to click on an inpatient medication, we could see a record of when, how much, and who gave the medication down at the bottom here. Unfortunately, we're not able to see this on a test patient, but I would encourage you to do these checks when you are giving a PRN medication or a medication that should be given within or beyond a certain time frame of the last dose. You can also use this information section to see the dose of the medication that was last given.